have a little whimper in the closet when your conscience gets so active you can't believe it. And you whimper and cry and ask God for a little help, and then you go right back with your hand and your eyeballs firmly attached. Oh yes, once in a while you take a dull paring knife and scratch your hand, and occasionally you scratch around your eyeball, but you haven't been down. You better listen to the words of Jesus. Not everyone who says, Lord, Lord, shall enter, but he that does the will of my Father in heaven. If ye by the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the flesh, ye shall live. If you live after the flesh, you'll die. The cross does not give us a minor shift or two with regard to a few of our ethical and moral and religious values. The cross radically disrupts the very center and citadel of your life from self to Christ. And if the cross has not done that, you're not a Christian! My friend, face it! Young or old, you're not a Christian! Until the cross has radically disrupted the very center and citadel of your life! Brought you from a life of commitment to serve self, whether it's religious self, moral self, proud self, covetous self, lustful self, prideful self, unforgiving self, lazy self. It doesn't matter what are the focal points of the reign of yourself. If you've gone to the cross in union with Christ, it's been shattered.
I speak unto thee this day, and I say it is me, the living God, who has given to the sons of men all of the provision that they have need of. That is, I've given unto them the light, I've given unto them the life, I've given unto them the washing of my word. And I say, if men would truly seek my face, my counsel, so would they be washed by my word. For I say it is me, the living God, who would cause them to be uplifted, brought forth, and ever guided in my way. Now I say this day that I, the living God, am at this time calling for all men to repent. And why is it so? I say it is because even those who are claiming they are mine are not allowing the washing of my word in their lives. That is, they are wanting to walk their own walk, to talk their own talk, and literally be far from me. But I say it is me, the living God, who is calling for them to repent, that they could be brought into union, communion with me. For I say that I, the living God, desire that men would be washed and washed and washed by my word as they walk through this life. That is, as they stay in the straight and narrow way, that their feet, that is, their walk, would be washed each day by me. For I say it is me, the living God, who came to earth as a man and gave demonstration of the washing of my word. That is, in the sense that I literally washed the feet of my disciples, that their walk would be clean with me. Now I say, so it is that I, the living God, desire to wash men in the waters of my word each and every day. For I say, when any man will be subject unto me, adhering unto me, and walking in my way, then he is brought forth by me. But I say, when men are rejecting the washing of my word, I say they are rejecting the very thing that will make them mine. For I say, it is me, the living God, who has given abundant provision, but I say that men proudly reject the same. Then I say they go about to establish their own way, and what do they gain? I say they gain the darkness, the evil, the iniquity of their own way, and yes, they are deceived by it all. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do not call you to deception, but I say that I call you to my life. And I say that I call you to be thankful that each and every day you are uplifted, guided, and brought forth in my way. And I say that I call you to be thankful that through me so are you given the blessedness, the truth, and the mercy time and again. For I say, when any will accept the washing of my word, they are accepting me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, absolutely do not find pleasure in those who are proudly rejecting what it is that I have for them, yet smugly assured that they are all right with me. For I say, such ones are blinded by pride. I say, they are taken far from my way. And I say, they are blinded by what it is that they esteem to be the great way, that is, their own way. Now consider, if men could make it their way, I say they would not need me. But all that they do when they take their own way is go in the way of destruction and damnation of soul. Now I say this day that I, the living God, am at this time giving forth to any and all who will hear and obey the greatness of my way. And I say that I'm calling for men, I'm calling for women to be ever found in me. For I say it is me, the living God, who is righteousness revealed. It is me, the living God, who is mercy and truth and hope provided. Therefore I say, when you will walk humbly in the repentant way, I say you are guided forth by me. And I say that you will be willing to accept my word, to apply my word, and let it cleanse thee. Now I say this day that I, the living God, desire that my own people would be cleansed as they walk day by day in me. That is, that they would allow the washing of the waters of my word to flow over them and cleanse them, that they can be in right standing with me. For I say that I, the living God, desire a people who are ever thankful that it is me that they serve. And I say that I desire a people who will be humble enough to accept my correction, my direction, and my instruction unto them. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do intend that you would come forth ever made glad in me. That is, I do intend that you would be thankful that it is me that you may look to and believe. For I say, if you are ever present in the power of my word, the power of my truth, then you are found abiding in me. And yes, you will be strengthened, for it is me, the living God, who will give thee the strength, the truth, the light, the mercy that I provide. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do intend that the ones who love me would walk uprightly, that they would be coming forth ever guided by me. And I say that I do intend that the ones who love me would be ever thankful to be given the truth and the light, the mercy, the strength of who I am. For I say it is me, the living God, who is the way of all righteousness, the way of all truth, and the way that is mercy provided. And it is me, the living God, who directs, corrects, and instructs the people who will indeed be subject to me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do call my people to be thankful that it is me that they can serve and not any other God. And I say that I call my people to willingly be submitted unto me and know my mercy in their lives. For I say it is foolishness to go in a way that is rebellious, to go in a way that is darkness, to go in the way of fools. And I say it is wisdom to come forth in the way that I offer to my own. Now I say this day that I, the living God, am at this time calling for any and all who will pay heed unto me to come forth in my way. And I say that I am at this time calling for the ones who will serve me to be given the light upon the path. For I say, when you really will see that I, the living God, am thy creator, and I have good intended for thee, how could you ever back up from me? That is, how could you resort to the way of the world, which is darkness, accusation, bitterness, and hatred, and the destruction of soul? Now I say this day that I, the living God, never called men and women to be wise in their own conceit. Yet I say, when pride settles in on them like a crown, that is exactly where they are. That is, they are taken in the crown of their own glory, so to speak, and they imagine they are some great thing. But I say they are under the auspices of delusion, and I say that the same will cause them to lose their souls. For I say they are choosing a way that is objectionable unto me, the way of a fool. I say this day that I, the living God, do not call you to go in the way of a fool, but I say that I call you to come forth in the way of the wise. And I say that I call you to be thankful that each and every day you can be uplifted, directed, and guided forth by me. And I say that I call you to be thankful that each and every day you are given the purpose, the truth, and the light time and again. For I say it is me, the living God, who is righteousness, mercy, truth, and hope provided. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do find my joy, I find my pleasure in a people who are indeed subject unto me. That is, in the ones who will be accepting and not rejecting of what it is that I give unto them. For I say, when you really consider the multiplied mercies that are found in me, and you are ever willing to accept the same, then you are guided forth by me. But I say, when you have a proud thought in your mind that you know more than you know, I say that the same is basically rebellion. For I say, when men swell up through pride, I say they puff on the same, then I say they hate humility and my humility way. And I say they hate the very image of lowliness, they hate the very image of repentance, and I say most of all they are hating me. And I say it is because they have been smitten by pride, and yes, they are defiant in the same. And I say they will grow defiant of me more and more as they stubbornly refuse to bend the knee. I say that I, a living God, do not call you to such a proud mindset as will destroy your soul, but I say that I call you to the humility way that I provide. And I say that I call you to be thankful that you can continue to trust me, believe me, and be guided forth by me. And I say that I call you to be thankful that through me you are given the light, the truth, and the mercy each and every day. For I say it is me, the living God, who gives to my own all that they ever have need of to be directed, corrected, and brought forth by me. Now I say this day that I, the living God, do intend that you would serve me with gladness and rejoicing, that you would serve me with thanksgiving, that you would serve me because it is me that you desire to please. For I say, if you truly will look upon what it is that I, the living God, do, I say that I give the way of eternal life. I say, if you look upon what it is that all of the spirits of deception do, I say they lead men to their own damnation. And I say they cause them to be separated from me, their maker, their creator, their God. Now I say this day that I, the living God, am indeed the God of all men in the sense that I have created and brought them forth. But I say that not all men are willing to recognize me as God, and I say they are the ones who pay for the same. For I say when men are refusing to recognize me, to walk uprightly in me, and be guided forth by me, what do they do? I say they go in a way of sorrow, despair, emptiness, and futility of soul. I say this day there are many who howl unto the wind. I say they moan, they groan, and it is all for naught. For I say they are simply taken in the throes of what they have chosen above me. And I say they have chosen the dictates of demons, they have chosen the directive of demons, and under the same they are slaves. For I say they are far from me, the one true God who would have brought them forth in eternal life. Therefore I say you can see fully why it is me, the living God, who continues to give forth the call to all men to repent. Now I say there are those who are lifted up in religious pride who will scoff the very principle of repentance and say that it is baby things. That is, they will say they have passed it up long ago and they do not need to repent. I say that is nothing but exhibition of pride, and I say they are desperately needy of repentance unto me. For I say if any man will scoff repentance, he is scoffing me. Now I say this day be thankful for the truth and the light, the mercy, the hope, and the peace that is found in me each and every day. And I say, be thankful that you are uplifted, guided, and directed in the way that I give, the way of life. I say, be thankful that you are given truth and mercy, strength and hope, and peace day by day. For I say, when you draw your strength of me, I say there is no enemy that can defeat the same. For I say that the strength that is found in me supersedes all the activity of demons that would seek to beset and overwhelm. For I say, when you trust me, believe me, and hope in me, so shall you see my mercy revealed. And so shall you see that I am the one who is able to guide you forth. And so shall you see that I am the one who gives to you newness of life. I say this day, be glad to continue, be glad to walk uprightly, be glad to be thankful unto me. And I say, be glad that I, the living God, do wash thee each day in the waters of my word. For I say it is my word that makes you clean if you allow the same. That is, if you allow the washing to cleanse the filth from thee, to cleanse the demons from thee, and continue in repentance before me. For I say that I, the living God, do have the way wherein men and women and children are meant to walk if they will be guided by me. And I say, when you welcome that way rather than fight against it, it is not difficult at all. But I say the difficulty comes to the sons of men because they rebel against me. That is, because of high-mindedness and pride and superiority in their estimation as to their own worth, they imagine they know more than they know. And I say in it all, they take themselves down the road of despair because they are not attentive unto me. But I say this day, if you will pay heed unto me and accept my word as the washing that you have need of, I say that you can be made clean. That is, each day that I, the living God, do give you what you need to wash the filth, the uncleanness, the vileness of this world from thee. That is, simply because you are existing in a fallen world, there are all manner of fallen demon forces about that will seek to latch on, that will seek to spoil, that will seek to defile my own. I say this day, be thankful for the privilege to be in the washing of my word each day, for it is me, the living God, who gives to you the same. And I say, be thankful to be guided, directed, and corrected by me. And I say, be thankful that I will bring you forth in that which I give, which is the truth always. For I say, it is me, the living God, who is righteousness revealed. It is me, the living God, who is mercy and hope and truth provided. Therefore, I say, be glad for the privilege to keep on serving, to keep on loving, to keep on following after. For I say, it is me, the living God, and me alone, who is the way provided, the humility way of life.
You never were made a doer of the will of God. You learned enough, and you learned what to say properly enough to be accepted for what you professed yourself to be on earth. But now that they have judged me,